Good afternoon, yo. It's your boy, Ben Barson. I'm back. It's fucking lit. I know you've been reading the tabloids and the newspapers or the publications. I'm about to be the Secretary of Health, nigga. What's good? Trump hold me down, baby. Only nigga in my crew, and I kick shit. Yo, listen, it's about to be lit. I'm about to be the Secretary of Health and Development of the United States of America, Donald Trump. I'm going to intro him, he's going to intro me, and he's going to put the Rockefeller chain on my breast. Never in your life have you opened the cranium of a giraffe, then restructured it to your liking. You can't fuck with me. Donnie, holla. Ben, I made a mistake here. I forgot that you were an African-American. So what's going to happen is I'm going to negate my offer to you. I'm going to grab you by the pussy and send you on your way. Please, security, come get him, please. Get him out of here. Yo, what's really good? Yo, Donnie, I thought we was boys. Can I rock? Please. Please. This is all I have. My book ain't selling no more. They're closing the Barnes and Nobles. Please, Donnie. Security, get this nigga out of here, please, immediately. I'm about to wash your shit. Yo, do the fucking drop. Get this guy out of here.
Live from Red Bull Studios, New York.
Somebody's getting an Oscar. Oh, yeah. Oh, fucking yeah. It's lit. Yo, episode 47 of the world's most dangerous podcast.
God damn.
In America.
Skittles.
And what's left of America. The embers of our tarnished nation.
Yo.
Just a gangbang eagle on the floor correcting itself. Yo, it's your boy, Desus Nice, man. A.K.A. Desus Vice, A.K.A. Young Chipotle, yeah. A.K.A. Pocket Stay Fat Like Cheerio, A.K.A. Tristaps for Sling Dick, A.K.A. Eli Litby, Boochers Boochers Gully, Slow But That Might Know Your Bitch, Young Day Party, Young Hot Take, Desus A. Twigo, Mr. Nando's with Gerando, Mio Novice de 94, Mikhail Going Off, The Juve Boss, MC Lico Gungapi, Putting Up From 40 with Your Shorty, A.K.A. Don't Talk To Me In The Uber Pool.
I don't know you, nigga.
The original My Plus One got a plus one, so don't make a fuss, son.
Don't do it.
Desus Rodstein, The Jamaican Jew, Jermaine Avocado Toast, Young Pa, The Ghost of Mufasa. Young Chacoonery out the Coonery, a.k.a. Chalila Lamone, the left-handed reliever for the Yankees.
Happy.
Que lo que. A.k.a. Vice K. Maxuzaka, a.k.a. Yeah. Two Phone Jones, a.k.a. Mr. La Marina, Mesh Marina, with a fresh misdemeanor, a cold demeanor, a.k.a. Leonardo DiTrapio, a.k.a. Wow. Your problematic bae.
Mwah. Wow. God damn. You know, we out here, dog. This is your boy, the Kid Mero, a.k.a. the Human Durag Flap, you know what I'm saying? Donovan McDabb, you know what I'm saying? Curve Gotti, you know what I'm saying? East Tree, my Stevie B, nigga, Ben Smack Biombo.
Ben.
Feel the ass Tyson. Triz Khalifa.
Ba, 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 ba.
You know what I'm saying? Skirt Loader, you know what I'm saying? Baby Newport. I know fucking baby.
He's a man.
I fucking man. You know what I'm saying? I open your medicine cabinet, so I hope that you have taken all the benzos out and put them in a safer location. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If you see me at Target, don't look me in my face. Approach me like a fucking bear.
Like a bear.
Also, you know what I'm saying? I can't say that no more because Trump's going to get me out of here. I got to start speaking straight English. Damn.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Ah! This plant ain't supernova in the sky. Woo! Damn, I'm smoking California weed, dog.
Woo!
God damn. Woo! Episode 47, Telemundo, nigga. Let's go.
Smoking on that gas.
That gas.
Yo,
that's shout out. That came through with the weed and was like, hey, dog, this is like exotic gas.
It's that gas.
This is like that gas.
This ain't that reg. This that gas.
Y'all put Matt A's in. Look at something like his gas.
like a high snake. Like, yes.
Gas.
Gas, niggas. As always, coming to you live from Red Bull Studios. Shout out to the sponsor. Red Bull Studios. Shout out to Narcan, K2.
That's right.
And we have a big announcement here. The whole world was waiting.
Yes, guys.
Right off the rip, we got to tell you.
Yes. Yes.
Congrats to Rob Kardashian and Blac Chyna on the birth of their child. Jean Kardashian!
Chyna had a dream.
Chyna had a dream. She's up for that Kardashian family. Get that church. No.
Psych.
No, actually.
More
importantly. We have big news. Big news.
Big tickets like wide.
I've come far from wild, from the forest, to bring ye a tale of to the Bodega Hive, of the birth.
That's right.
Of the first little Bodega princess.
That's right.
Yes, she is.
The only one.
The one that Sir Mero created with his penis.
My precious.
She will now be born to the world.
Yes.
She will wear door knockers.
That's what it was. With her name in the middle.
Congrats to Mero. Shouts to Mero and shouts to us. Now we don't have to put up with four little Meros. World is safer.
Y'all got lucky.
Trump is keeping his promises.
I'm going to make sure Mero has a daughter so there's no more Meros involved in the world.
That's why I voted for him. It's not because of the racism. It was just I just didn't feel comfortable with another Mero in the world. I mean, just how much pitching is the Yankees going to have?
I mean, it's basically over after the fourth inning.
Also, why all the jerseys say Martinez? Like, come on. Like, remember when baseball didn't have tilly ads over the names?
Remember that? Yo, when my kids play for the Yankees, they're still putting the jerseys, the names on the back of the jerseys.
It's going to be like, you play for the, like, suck my dick. fuck you. I've been a DH since I was 8 years old. I signed my first contract at 9. You don't tell me what to do.
You don't tell me what to get out of my face. Yo, wow. Yeah, wow. You know what I'm saying? Blessings are blessings. Thank you to my bros. You know what I'm saying?
For here.
You know what I'm saying?
We helped make the baby.
Holding it down.
Where he was, we was giving that long dack. We was stroking his back like, going home, boy. Like, we was at skate key.
Through the water.
Like, yo.
The water my head like I ran a marathon and
yo,
shit.
Yo, giving you a couple cup of Henny. Like, yo, keep going. You're almost there. Shot words of encouragement. Like, woo! Come on!
Atta boy!
You in the home stretch! We got up like there was two strikes and two outs. I was like, woo!
I had the wild bat weight on my dick and shit, like swinging the shit around.
You had the bat, you had the pintar shit, like, yo, for the good grip.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta grip the D. Yo.
Oh, man.
Oh, man. But yeah.
Yo, shout out to you making more babies just as the world is ending.
Yo, it's so wild.
President Donald Trump.
He wouldn't be.
How? Not even how. We know.
That was the one Mero Diamonds that I fucking regret to the fullest, B.
You predicted that? Like, you did call it.
I was like,
Mero don't know what he's talking about. Yeah. Nate Silver was like, Mero don't know what he's talking about. Hillary Clinton was like, that Mero, nigga don't know what he's talking about.
Get him out of here.
Poor Hillary. She was working on her folk stance for like the acceptance speech.
Oh, man.
She get her dance.
She was
off.
So hyped. She had Russell Westbrook on speed dial. Like, yo, we're going to come out. It's going to be lit. It's going to be pyrotechnics. Oh, man. She was about to do a swag surf and shit. Mm-hmm. Bro, it was mad sad, though. But if you see, like, when she lost, like, her whole headquarters, they're all like, looking like 9/11 status, being like mad, full of tears, like Tower. They just watched Tower 2 fall and shit.
It's sad.
Sad.
It's sad, but now it's like, yo, the reality is Trump is president, and I think a lot of people, like, it hasn't hit people yet, but when it really hits everybody, they're gonna be like, yo, what do we do?
It hit me yesterday when I was on Twitter, and somebody pushed up one of his old ass tweets where he was like, Mark Cuban is a loser, like faggot, or some wild, like disgusting shit like that. People didn't say that. I'm just some wild slanderous, but whatever.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. But like something like that. And I looked at it, and then I clicked it, and I went to his profile, and it said 45th president-elect of the United States, Donald Trump. I was like, damn, this nigga's like, really the president.
Are they about to be president of the United States of America, have access to nuclear codes, and he's a Twitter, he is a thirsty Twitter honey and couldn't run to put Dog. Wait to put it in his bio.
Oh my god.
That's the most unpresidential shit. Don't be putting that you're gonna be running a country in your bio.
Before you
That's
even
for
there?
Lying about your ethnicity and countries you haven't been to.
Come on.
And when you graduated college.
And plane emojis. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, get out of here. Yo, your man, if he fires off nukes like he fires off bad tweets, dog, We're done. We are in trouble.
He's flip flopping on tweets already. Last night he did. He was against the protest. This morning he's for it. He's like live tweeting his day. They put a barricade all around Trump Tower. Like the big truck sanitation shit.
Yeah. He probably feels like Nino up in there. Like,
yeah, it's the Carter.
I'm a fucking man. Like,
I'm a man.
What a worm.
Ivanka, give me that Slovenian topic. You can't even talk like that anymore. She's the first lady now. She's going to be the first lady.
That's wild, bro.
And you can't touch, they say you're not supposed to slut shame because she got nudes floating out there.
But so, I mean, she was a model. Like, whatever. Models you know be getting naked. Who cares?
Yeah, and it's not like, they were like, I guess, tasteful nudes. It's not like she was like, you know, like fucking
sucking
a tiger
a
or some
dick.
Shit.
Yeah, some wild shit.
I mean, you don't know what happened to Russia.
Hey.
Sylvania.
You know what I'm saying? Let's look at the dash cams. <It's> true. See what happened.
Yo, America is fucked.
Yeah,
and you can't even be happy about it because it's like, we live here?
Yeah.
And who's the first people that's going to be affected? Well, not us anymore.
I mean, we're getting a little bread.
We're getting out the hood.
So
I'm going to live on a boat in the Hudson. Walk barefoot.
You'd be
time.
Like, yo, this is international waters.
I don't recognize your sovereignty.
On the Bronx River and shit on the yacht. Like,
The standoff with Desus Nice on his living yacht.
39th day of this standoff. My goodness.
Who could imagine that a man can live that long in 3 feet of water?
He's now eating dolphins out of the Hudson. It's out of control.
Janet Reno's ghost comes back and sets my boat on fire. Too soon?
Yo, RIP Janet Reno. Yo, she went in there. Yo, she was in there throwing Mazel Tov cocktails like at Waco.
With the Branch Davidians. Branch Davidians. They had like buried a school bus on the compound.
Buried a school bus?
Yeah, if you guys don't remember the Branch, this is a wash fact.
Yeah.
It's also a nice Dark Jesus fact.
Yeah. It was like 94, though. It was not like wash.
Nah, that was, 94 was like mad long ago, though.
Yeah, it was, damn. It's like 20, what was it, 25 years ago? 20, math. 20? 24? 94, yeah. 22? Mm-hmm. Victor just touched his glasses and immediately got the answer. All
right. Now, the Branch Davidians, you know, they were a religious group. They were like
a cult.
Yes, you can use that term. You could use that term. They had their Waco siege.
Was it a Christian?
That was 1993.
Was it a Christian thing, or was it just like some whole other shit?
No, they were like a schism from Seventh-day Adventists.
Okay.
So like, right. It's just like, the guy was like, nah, he was like, yo, y'all could go to their church, or y'all come to my church, and we could all be like, y'all could be my wives and shit, I'll be fucking y'all, and I'm fucking y'all daughters, and you know what I'm saying? Shit. Y'all live here, and y'all make your own clothes, and buy mad guns.
You buy mad guns, drink GHB together, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? I see the appeal. That's what Donald Trump is doing.
I mean,
to a different level.
He's out here doing kind of.
He got the people. Shout out to all the white women that held him down in the voting.
Shout out to y'all are bugging. Like, he was basically like, yo, I will grab you in the pussy. Like,
that's locker room talk.
Yeah, right. He says, didn't he say also, like, yo, you got to treat women like shit or some shit? He got quoted as that saying that. I'm dead ass. Like, look it up.
Maybe.
It's on the internet.
See, that's the thing. Like, I don't even feel like the need to look that up, because that sounds like something he would say.
It sounds very believable. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But hey.
He was skied up with Luke. That's and Mike Tyson, happened. Allegedly. I feel like he definitely would sue a podcast.
Oh, he's mad petty. That's
he's
what I'm saying.
Super fucking petty.
Come on. He's on some old hustling, trying to make money shit, like doing schemes like with infomercials and Trump University and Trump Stakes and mail order shit. He's mad old, nigga. Like, and he'll definitely sue some niggas like on some petty shit.
Oh,
like,
yeah. Hell yeah. And not even for a lot of money, just for like the joy of this shit.
Yeah, just to be like, yo, go to court, you piece of shit.
I'll tell you this, though. If he did, I definitely, I'm jumping him in the courtroom.
Oh, for sure.
Fuck that, got nothing to lose.
Bailiff ain't holding me down.
Beat that nigga. I was going to ruin Moonlight for y'all, but nah. So.
Yo, man, get him out of here. But we can't OD on him now because he's actually about to be the president.
We going harder. We have a larger platform. We go hard on him pretty, realized that.
But
that,
I'm just saying, like, yo, if I see you on Tremont, I'm going to snuff you type of shit.
Well, yeah, you can't do that. Yeah. I feel we're going to get some Secret Service visits. I mean, it's going to happen. They're going to be like, Desus. I'm like, Officer Ramirez.
Yeah, okay.
How's your wife? He's like,
oh. Ramirez, go get Desus. Ramirez, go get Mero. Ramirez, secure the roof.
No, because I was watching TV and like no one else was going hard against him. And then I look on our show, Desus and Mero, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday on Viceland. Critically acclaimed, also.
Yeah.
A lot of funny people watch it. A lot of important people watch it.
You know what I mean?
But yeah, like we were flaming him from the election night. Everyone else was like, yo, peace and calm, blah, blah, blah. And we was like, oh, get the gallery.
Get him out of here.
So I guess we're the voice. We're the voice of the young generation, Little Mama.
Every time I hear Little Mama's name mentioned, the image that immediately pops in my head is her standing next to Jay-Z doing the fucking like B-boy stance.
Between Jay-Z and Alicia Keys.
Alicia Keys? I was like, yo, get this lady out of here.
Oh, man.
Shut the Little Mama, though.
Little Mama out here cooking. I thought Sausage would have been a bigger song.
Yeah. I mean, wasn't it a meme also? Not a meme, like a viral thing for a little bit?
It was,
Sausage. And then people go around on in a circle.
You heard your boy. You heard about Bartolo Colon?
What happened?
He's going to the Braves.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, dog. Why don't you just come back to the Yankees, dog?
No.
Come on, man.
$12.5 million with the Braves.
He's out here, yo. He had a fucking renaissance. Yo, your man came out in like 95.
He's been around forever.
He's been cooking.
He's been around forever. He give dad bods like...
Yo,
like, you're life. Like, why even go to the gym? Look at this nigga.
I was like, fuck the gym.
This nigga hit home runs.
I'll be carrying like 3-4 kids around me. Like, I go up and down stairs a lot. Like, I'm good. Fuck the gym. You know what I'm saying?
Run up and down tree. Is he like popping in DR?
If he goes back to DR, he is getting choked as soon as he lands. Immediately. Right. Like, he's popping.
Baseball quality choked or just like...
Quality. Yeah. Like, yeah, because he got bread, bro. Yo, if you're a millionaire here, you're a billionaire in DR. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, if you make a million here, you go over there, fam, you're so good. And you're not even exposed to, like, people. Because, yo, you would think, like, yo, it's a developing nation. Mm-hmm. If I got mad money, niggas going to come get me. If you got a lot of money, you don't even got to worry about that. You got security, mad guns and shit. Like, it's not like here. Like, here you got to be like, I got to get a license to get a handgun. Over there, you'd be like 50 AKs in the crib. Like, it's nothing.
I love it. You know what I'm saying? I love it. That would help when when we take over Antigua.
You know what I'm saying? Escobar style, you build your own jail.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I have a tiger on my porch.
Like, hell yeah. That'd be, yo, I can't wait to do stupid shit like that. Get exotic animals.
Yeah. They should have an Uber for getting exotic animals.
They should.
Well, no, probably not. I feel like someone would abuse that late at night and shit.
That, I mean, like, that's the only purpose of
it.
Up.
Yeah, this is like, yo, I need some penguins and shit.
85% of like exotic animal Uber uses is fucking skeet up. Like, let's be real. It's 4 a.m. You're wild skeet up. You're like, yo, you want to go have on this tiger with me?
Yo, what the fuck? You know this house needs a fucking hippopotamus. Pull out the phone like, doo-doo.
Yo, yeah. Yo, get a hippo. Yo, they can crush you with their jaws, bro.
Put this watermelon in his mouth.
Yo, check it out. Yo. Oh, they could really fuck up a watermelon, too.
They could crush your head. Hippos kill people all the time.
Really?
Yeah. Hippos are very dangerous.
Damn.
In Africa.
Africa.
And in specific, I would say a specific country, but that doesn't matter anymore because Trump is president.
Yeah, Africa's
so we just
country.
Took Africa's just one big place now. Yeah. Where we're all going back.
Africa, China, Russia, Asia.
See? When people on Twitter and they're like, go back to Africa. It's like, could you be more specific? Where would you like me to go?
Like sub-Saharan. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Are you paying for my ticket?
The Cape.
What about my relocation costs? Yeah. You can explain to my boss because I'm still, I'm under contract. So I can't just.
You gonna send me somewhere with civil unrest? Like, it's really good.
I don't feel like you even thought out this idea of me going back to Africa.
Like, I think you're just fucking pulling up from 50 and missing. You fucking dicks.
My mentions are a mess.
Back. Yeah, I mean, shout out to assholes on Twitter.
I got Trump, the deplorables. They be in my shit now because of they feel emboldened by President Trump.
That's what it is, man. I keep telling y'all, man. Like, it's not Trump himself. It's the fact that he started up this fucking hornet's nest of racist people that were like being low key, and now they're like, oh, it's okay. Like, I could just be racist out here. It's normal. Bet
he's out here. I'm all the racist.
They just expose themselves.
Expose them.
Yeah, that's what happened. So now, shout out to Trump, and now
it's gonna be a weird I was gonna say it's gonna be a bit weird 4 years. It's already weird.
Yeah, it shouldn't even start yet. Barry's still out here. We already forgot. Like we already like.
Yeah, it's like Barry. He's like creeping out and shit. Yeah, he's like, we're going by Obama's desk. Like the computer's on, but no one's in the chair.
Yeah, screensaver's been on for mad long. Like,
I don't think he's been here in a while.
There's a glass of water there with mad dust on the top. Like,
I don't think Barry's been at his. His phone got that one fucking voicemail like flasher like.
It says 9-8. Like, yo, what the fuck?
Where's he at? Where he at, though?
Where they at? Yo, he's out. He's playing ball and shit. Like, he's like, yo, I'm out of here.
He met with Donald Trump yesterday.
Yeah.
So.
And it's mad funny because all the pictures that you see online is of him looking at the camera like, see?
Boy.
See what y'all did?
See what y'all did?
See what y'all done did?
He's looking at us the way, like, your mother looks at you. Like a little kid when you like
when you fuck up
like a parent teacher night, you sit in the chair, he's like,
yeah,
scolding America for the poor choice.
That's right. And you know you about to go home and get your ass whipped. America, you about to get your ass whipped.
Ooh.
So get ready
because you want to miss the Brexit. Oh, you know what, he might not actually be horrible. It might be worse. He might just be a puppet for like special interest groups and shit and just making deals and making his pockets fat.
I mean, that's what's, and it's funny because I'm like, everybody's like, yo, it's gonna incite a race war. It's gonna be wild. I'm like, nah, he's just gonna be the wild. Yeah, he's from Queens. He's just gonna be the wild shill and just sell out and just be like, yo, who's got the most money? Holla, cut the check. Like, let's make it happen, baby. Like, wheeling and dealing in the fucking Oval Office instead of doing like actual, presidential shit.
Mm hmm. My father was going to vote for Trump, but he doesn't vote, so.
Shout out to him for not
voting. So I canceled. He was just explaining it, and I was like, boop, you don't vote. Quiet for you.
My mom votes straight Democrat. Shout out to her. And she just picks the most Latino-sounding names if she doesn't know. Like,
fair.
For judges and shit like that. Like, and I'm like, yo, you know what? That's my strategy.
I was going to say they should have a picture of the candidate next to their name.
That's true.
No.
No.
I don't think after this last election, I don't think that would help anything. No.
You just see a dude up there, his name is like fucking Mike Smith and shit. You're just like,
But you see the picture, it's like a picture of me.
I'm going to pick Martin Shkreli.
Sorry. You know what it is? It's like, Well, no, our voting. I was gonna say something about like going in the booth, but our voting thing didn't have booths. So, but there's probably an analogy there about the old, like, I guess in the, like, I've seen some places where they still have booths with the curtains and shit. Oh. So that's kind of like putting on a KKK robe, right?
I mean, kind of, yeah.
Right?
It is.
You're hiding behind fabric.
You're shrouded.
Mm-hmm.
At least with these new shits, like, you could, like, you're out there. It's just like a little windshield that blocks your fucking scantron. You know what I'm saying? A privacy shield.
Yeah.
The old shit was just like, yo.
That fucking.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't trust this new shit, though. It's, like, digital.
Yeah, I don't trust digital shit. See? That's what I'm saying. Am I washed?
No.
Because I don't trust the cloud. I don't trust digital shit. I don't trust swiping everything all the time, everywhere. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know, man. Maybe it's, like, maybe I'm, like, hesitant to join the future and shit.
No, because digital is a Babylon ting.
It's a Babylon. Pure Babylon ting.
The cloud.
That's pure Babylon ting.
Pure Babylon ting.
Yo.
The only cloud is Jah.
Yo. That shit just sounds wild hackable. Like...
It's just, it's come on, like, we said, how, like, we know Russia hackers was fucking with the election, and then we have, like, election machines, like,
oh, come on. Like,
we need to go back to pebbles. Everyone gets a rock mailed to them, everyone that's an American citizen, and you bring your rock to the polling station, and you put it in a bucket.
Yep.
I don't know how we're going to count that, but,
I mean,
listen, I don't have all the answers. If I did, that's the beauty of America. We try and fail. Yeah. So if my rock thing, my rock voting system doesn't work,
we'll try something else. You know what I'm saying? We'll go back to the drawing board. Why not? I think that it should be mandatory for you to vote if you can.
Mm-hmm.
And you should do it like with your taxes. Like when you file your taxes,
right,
you also vote. Like it would change the whole way the campaigns and like voting is set up or whatever. But like it's just, it would happen at boom at one time. And like everybody has to vote. So everybody gets.
And what happens if you don't vote?
I don't know.
That's a punishment.
Not a punishment, but like you should maybe like you get your license suspended. Your license suspended or something like, well, because I don't think you should punish people for not voting if they're like on some conscientious objective shit. Maybe you get an extra tax break if you vote. You know what I'm saying? You get a voting tax break.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And if you don't vote, you don't get that tax break.
Mm, but then you're like putting a profit or something, you know, like that's not.
I mean, money motivates people to do everything.
It shouldn't be.
It shouldn't be. It should be, all you need is love. Get the fuck out of here, nigga. You need money. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, money motivates people. Money talks, me. Money. People will do anything for money. I know you've seen the Brazzers, you know?
That is true. That is true. I've seen.
Money
talks. I've just seen poor women unable to pay for pizzas.
You know what I mean? Pizza guy just shows up, happens, you know, to have his dick in the box.
Sometimes the rent is late.
You know what I mean?
You know, sometimes you have the pawn shop.
Hey.
You know? These are all likely scenarios.
Very likely. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of those scenarios are just like, wow, this is just straight sexual harassment.
Like, what is this?
Like, your boss can't really just ask you, like, can't just turn to you and be like, I want to put my dick in your butt.
Yeah, like,
and that's you just roll up.
Yeah.
The chick just rolls up her skirt.
It's not
just
allowed.
Like,
that's
it's already
allowed.
Lubed up. No, that's not real life.
That's not allowed.
It'll definitely be like, ouch, what?
I seen a pino where Shorty went, like, a dude goes into a sportswear store or whatever, mm-hmm. and he's trying on jeans and shit. And Shorty comes into the thing, and he's, like, has his dick out. And she's like, oh, my God. And then, like, 10 seconds later, they're smashing.
Well,
I was like, I don't know. That doesn't happen.
No one watches porn for dialogue drama or setup. Like,
you know what? Why'd you even bother with this?
But then it feels weird if, like, you just turned it on, and they're just, like, fucking out.
Fucking immediately?
You need some backstory.
Yeah.
Where'd they meet? What's their mutual interest? You know?
What's the motivation to smash right now?
You know? Was she having a hard day?
You know?
Is he an escape con looking for a house to hide in?
Is he a masseuse that,
anything's
she
possible.
She asks him to do things,
Anything's possible. And then you never find out the ending.
But yo, like you were saying, though, like, oh yeah. Like you were saying, like, you know, motherfuckers are sick because of, like, the scenarios that you get in most pinos. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. Like, bro, I don't really, like...
Smack city.
You see me just trail off?
You just trail off.
It's like...
You did like a it's not a dope fiend nod, but you just... I just saw your consciousness, like... Yeah. For like a second there, you literally were, like, outside of Neptune. Like, just floating in the cosmos, like... Oh, Neil deGrasse Tyson behind you, like... Ironically, Mero's the last time Mero was this smack, the Cubs had not won a World Series yet. Neil deGrasse Tyson facts.
Facts.
He's with the action thieves.
He's out here. What's the name of the show? Cosmos? Cosmos?
Yeah, it's not. That was like a series.
It's old.
It's done.
Yeah.
But it was cool. It was
on Netflix, all right?
Probably. I don't really fuck with Netflix like that.
No?
I don't understand how. Where
do you
people...
watch your stuff on?
I watch my stuff on regular cable the way God intended it.
Oh, true. Subscribe to Vice Link right now if you don't got
No, like, I don't... I was going to say I don't understand how you people have time to watch Netflix and stuff, but that's not true. I'm lazy. I don't want to, like, watch it while I'm, like, in the car and driving and on train. I was on a train yesterday, you know, it was, you know, I remember how to use a Metro card.
Yeah.
Okay, I one swipe, baby.
Yeah.
Still got it.
I took a train today, and I pulled my Metro card, blind pull.
Mm-hmm.
Whoop, swiped it.
Still got it.
Cash. Like, let's go.
My Metro card swipe was so beautiful. I thought, like, that shit was going to turn into, like, the wild Bollywood dance sequence on the other side. Like,
Jesus swipe. Perfect swipe.
Yo! Speaking of which.
You swipe your Metro card in your head.
No.
Da-da-da.
Everyone should be a good person.
Okay.
And I know that comes out of nowhere randomly. Yesterday, I was going out for drinks late at night.
Uh-huh.
And I was going through the 6th train and Grand Central. As I was going through, I saw my pet peeve. There was a woman in front of me, a younger Latina girl, maybe like 16. She was fumbling with her Metro card because I think she had done that swipe shit. She swiped it too fast and it said, just use.
Right.
And she couldn't get back on the train or some shit. And she was pulling back the turnstile to go, you know how like you can go through that way?
Yeah, yeah.
And as I look up, I see a lady with headphones, like on the other side of the turnstile. I see a lady with headphones and a Yankee hat. Mm-hmm. And over here is like two guys, like one guy's on a cell phone, but the other guy's just kind of looking around. Clearly DTs. So, you know, I have my choice. I'm like, can I be a good Samaritan and warn her? Or can I pull out my phone and record this? Because this is about to be wild lit. But I said, God's working on all of us.
Okay.
And I stopped her and I was like, yo, this cop's right there. Would you like a swipe? And I gave her a swipe. And she genuinely, like, her face was like, thank you. I don't know what she was going through. And then, that's my Good Samaritan story.
Yo, thank you. I told you for that because...
And I did that because I was thinking about you and your daughter. And I was like, we need a better world for her.
Chill. Like, I'm about to get mad about you, know? Yo. Come on, son.
We need a better world. We got to do things for the little duns.
That's true. Yo, listen. If you are very, like, nihilist and shit, and you're like, yo, fuck the world, don't be like that. You know what I'm saying? Because, yo...
No, it's still nihilist. Like, don't get this shit twisted. Dark teeth is still up in this, bitch. This whole place going to end. You think Christmas is going to be fun? Yeah. Black Friday?
Yo, Hanukkah and Christmas Eve are the same day this year.
Are they?
Yes. And the first night of Hanukkah and Christmas Eve are the same, I think. I'm pretty sure.
Who decides this?
I don't know.
Big Jew?
Yeah, I don't know. Yo, the fucking, the calendar, yo, the Jewish calendar be fucking me up. I don't even, it's like year 58, 70, Hive helped me out. You know what I'm saying? But that sucks, B, because it's usually like around November.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know usually, but it has been for me. So then you get like Christmas and then Christmas again.
So are you saying it sucks because you have to buy gifts or
both?
You're getting gifts.
You're just getting gifts like all at once. So it's like you're not going to get as much shit as you would have got if they were further apart. You know what I'm saying?
That is what neither of those holidays is about, though.
I mean, it's not, but, you know, it's also the spirit of giving. I give, you know what I'm saying?
I'm going to tell your wife that this year you guys shouldn't give gifts. You should give hugs.
Okay. She'll be like, fuck out of here.
You got to teach your kids a different way, Heather.
Yeah. Now, her favorite thing to do is hit, like, sales before Christmas. And get and Hanukkah shit and get a bunch of shit like very like cheaply.
Yeah.
And then like brag about it until people get the gifts. Shit like,
all right, I mean,
it's like I got $2,000 worth of toys for $350. So
that's wild.
I'm out here cooking.
See, like I'm a terrible person to buy gifts for because anything I want, like if I just buy it for myself.
You so, do? What about gift cards? So answer me this because people tell me this all the time. If I'm like, yo, I'm gonna get Desus something for Christmas, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I'm not sure what to get. I'm like, yo, this nigga knows everything about sneakers. I can't get him a pair of sneakers that he won't already have or whatever, or clothing, or whatever. If I just get you a gift card to a place that you fuck with, is that appreciated or is that like, yo,
that's
this is mad impersonal?
That's very much appreciated. That's very much appreciated.
It's mad people like, yo, that's mad impersonal. Like, people, you didn't put any thought into it, blah,
blah,
like blah.
Some people like a specific gift. But in my situation, that would be like, I'd be like, yo, good looking out. I could use the gift card with the bots or whatever, online or whatever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You gotta know the situation, Mero.
Yeah, come on, bro.
You gotta
don't
be
shaming me
TNEs.
For getting gift cards, man.
But you can't be getting like people like whack gift cards also. Like, don't come here with a fucking $100 voucher for Dallas BBQ, my nigga. I'll be like, yo, really? That's what you think? Yo, ma, yo.
Free Texas size with Andre.
Yo, ma.
She's the wild whack coupon.
Yo, ma, enjoy this Weight Watchers joint. Like, no, you can't do that.
Well, yo. You fuck with Dunkin' Donuts, right?
Not really.
$5, my nigga.
Not really.
Holla.
I once got a $20 gift card for my birthday for someone, and I was like, What? For Chipotle. And I was like,
okay.
I was like, you know, I'm an adult, right?
They're like, well, you're young Chipotle. So, I was like, I mean,
this didn't, this like, this like one Chipotle meal, and then I'm left with a weird balance that I can't do anything
with. It's like MetroCards. You swipe your shit, you got 37 and a half cents on the shit. Like,
and then I gotta refill it. Now I gotta walk around with a Chipotle card, like, for mad months and shit, like, in case I ever want.
You go back to refill, you hand it to niggas, shit is mad scuffed. Like, it's from 2 years
ago. I can't read this. I can't read this, sir.
Put the bag on it, man. Stop playing.
I can't.
Just type in the number, nigga.
I can't.
Come on.
I have to get my manager.
Oh, my God. Yo, fine.
I think he's Chipotle scamming.
Yo, hurry the fuck up, nigga. What the fuck is, yo? What the fuck, nigga? Gift card's mad old. Yo, come on, son.
Sir. Sir. Not in Donald Trump's America. White people just. White people just marching to Chipotle, like, shut this down. This isn't American food.
Get him out of here.
Deplorables! The deplorables are here!
The first step in removing Chipotle is I'm going to remove the sneeze guards from the guac so that niggas sneeze in the guac.
Kill Obama!
Shout out to Obama, scream kill Obama at the fucking...
at the press conference.
Yo.
No, it's not shout out to him. It's shout out to everyone around him that was like, all right. And that's what happened with the vote.
Bruh.
Everyone, you have your racist uncle... Your racist auntie.
Yo, is your duty?
They told you. You saw their Facebook feed.
Yeah.
You saw they were going to vote for Trump. And you was like, all right, well, that's just my whimsical aunt, Chester.
No. Nope. It's your duty. Fuck. It's your duty to take the hat off their head and roof it. If they're your family. You can't just be going roofing strangers' hats.
No. What about dude on the L train?
Chuck Johnson?
Chuck Johnson.
He's a herb. I'm like, yo, I would have rocked his shit.
Ooh.
Yo, at that second, and with the second time, he's like, fuck off. I would have been like, word? Rang! Nigga,
yo,
hold that.
We be in Williamsburg. We be in Williamsburg. Yo, I'm just saying. God.
I would have washed his shit, bro.
We like, never caught a homeboy that called us niggas. Someone got to get these hands.
Someone got to collect.
Someone got to get him. Listen, these mitts, they got rain checks on them, man. Well, they ain't expiring no time soon.
And it's wild because, like, I said that shit, and then mad people jumped on my benches being like, yo, like, if he would have did something, like, y'all would have been like, oh, he's a wild Trump supporter. I'm like, bruh, all Donald Trump did was amp y'all up to fight, and like every time somebody that did not agree with y'all went to these rallies, they was getting pushed around, spit on, and shoved. So like y'all
been
violence.
Doing that.
Like, that's what y'all been.
That's
like,
y'all language. We just speaking y'all language.
That's all. You know what I mean? If I slap the shit out of you, you know what I'm saying, and take your Trump hat and throw it in the bump.
Also,
on the
that's
train,
not really even anti Donald Trump. Thing. That's like a New York thing.
Yeah.
Because you're not going to come in New York. Like, you're not coming through New York with like a Confederate flag hat.
Nah.
And you're going to think you're good money on the train.
Nah.
All right?
No.
You put on a hat like that or a Donald Trump hat and you're on the train.
Violate
your
shit.
Creating a situation. Are creating a tense situation that might get scary.
That's right. We don't get down like that
dangerous.
Over here. We don't get down like that over here. So, I mean,
listen,
if you want to come through and
there's
test,
freedom of
test
speech,
it.
But then, like, there's also, let's be reasonable, my nigga.
Yeah.
All right? these are two very separate and distinct things. The Constitution says you can say whatever the fuck you want to say, wherever the fuck you want to say it.
You know?
All right? God bless. That's all good. Don't be on 125th Street calling people all types of niggas and thinking that shit's going to end well for you. You know what I'm saying?
It's probably not going to end well.
You know? Someone's shaking the table. All right? They're not having Klan rallies in Eden World Projects.
Straight up.
For a reason.
So, That's the temperature out here, man. So if you want to come here and think it's hot, then take your jacket off.
I was about to say it's time for the tea report and then talk about that girl that threw the hot water on her. But that's not,
bro.
That's not the same tea.
And when you said that, I thought that you were gonna say shorty that pushed shorty in front of the Trisnington. I was like,
oh wow,
no. I was like, damn, that is extremely dark.
That is dark. No, that's not tea. That's dark report.
That's wild dark.
No, a lady pushed another lady in front of a train. 42nd Street. I was at that station today.
Times Square, dog.
I was looking around. I was like, I can see how it happens.
Man, hot boy. Like, that is the most hot boy. Like, if you do anything wild out there, you're really wilding. Like,
damn.
That's where the cops have, like, machine guns. You know what I'm saying?
But pushed her in front of the train. And they think she might have pushed another person in front of a train.
And they thought it was a suicide, right? Yeah,
because she had just broken up or something. But,
oh,
damn.
My God.
That's the worst way. That's one of the worst ways to go out in New York.
Get hit by train. Because, yo, not only is it fucking mad gruesome and terrible, definitely closed casket funeral, people on the train are like, yo, fuck this nigga, man.
Well,
also, it might not be quick.
Yeah.
And there's mad people on the train cursing your existence, which is mad foul, but
hey, you can't hear it because you, like, fucked up by the train.
Yeah. You a fucking human fajita on the train tracks.
God bless.
That sucks.
That's a terrible way to die in New York City.
Oh, good. That, but, or drowning in the Hudson.
Yeah. Or an air conditioner unit just falls out a window, crushes you.
Fuck. Yo, New York City got the worst ways to die, baby.
Yeah, they're not normal. They're exotic ways to die.
Not exotic. Like,
that's why you pay the high rent, because you don't. Because you can't die like that in like some other city and shit. Runaway horse just tramples you.
Just tramples you and shit.
Got guests in the back of the carriage.
Like, you get hit by Mr. Softy truck. You know what I'm saying? That took a corner too hard.
One of those roasted peanut carts just rolls over you, just gets out of control.
This shit just falls on you, you get lit on fire with peanuts. Yo, they're just roasted with Mad Honey roasted peanuts, like, Yo.
You're coming up the steps of the soup. You're coming up the steps of the subway, and one of the fucking Elmos in Times Square loses balance, falls back and crushes you, breaking your neck.
Yo, remember that movie where the fucking kids, I think it was like Brad Pitt and like Kevin Bacon and shit? Oh, they were kids in Hell's Kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
And they were fucking with some dude who was like a hot dog vendor or some shit. Oh, they stole hot dogs from a hot dog vendor. The dude came and chased them. They pushed him down some stairs, and the cart fell on him, crushed him to death, and he died. And they all went to like a juvenile facility.
Was that Boondock Saint?
No, no, no. That was just some wild Irish dude shooting mad shit up.
But it was no. It was something like it was. So, it had like some shit about an Irish name or clovers or something in the title.
It's something like that. It was just one word. Clovers, dreamers. Wasn't dreamers. Sleepers? Was it sleepers?
Sleepers? Maybe sleepers?
Yeah, sleepers.
After a prank goes disastrously wrong, a group of boys are sent to a detention center. Yep.
Yep. Where they get wild molested by Kevin Bacon.
Yes, I remember this. Yes. Woo!
Yo, that was
and
a wild
And then they come back after 10 years.
Yep.
Shout out to Mero with the 1996 movie reference.
Yo, that was an old movie. They came back and, I mean, I'm not going to ruin for y'all if y'all want to watch it.
Yeah, it's a good movie.
Yeah, go watch it.
Shout out to Mero. Mero, mentioned in movies. Hey. And if you'd like to watch Sleepers, it's available right now for $2.99 on Amazon Video. Amazon Video, the best place to find video.
Yo, it's mad hell because we're like, yo, fuck it, we're never going to do ads. Fuck ads. And we just be doing ads for no reason.
You know what? Some of that Amazon Video is like,
how the fuck?
They're like, did you?
The social media guy is going to be at the meeting. They're going to be like, Bill, you're fucking amazing.
How'd you get the placement?
How did you do that?
How much?
How do you know them? These guys are awesome millennials.
They're
going
to call. They're like, so what was that? Like 3 mil? That was like 3 mil for that placement.
He's like, No. Oh, no, no, no. I got it. I know one of the guys. I know Vic. Visas.
The one that looks like Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
That one.
Yep.
Yep, that's my nick. That's my homeboy.
So yeah, by the way, I was gonna ask for a 58% raise.
Oh. Yo,
damn, you know what's thinking about raises and Christmas and shit like that? Like regular niggas getting raises?
Regular niggas. Jesus. Wow.
Nah, I said that on purpose, just to be a dick.
First of all, I'm a regular nigga. There's a regular nigga in the room.
No. Are you bugging? Chill, this dude has been in Ibiza, fam.
I know.
I've never been to Ibiza. You've been in Ibiza. That's not regular. Like,
he's been plenty of times.
You know what I'm saying? He's probably on a plane to Sweden in like an hour. You know what I'm saying?
He could do the wild flex. Like, we get to the airport and like he knows where to get the luggage before like we like we're still trying to figure out the size and shit. He's like, nah, this way. Just go this way. God, jeez.
He just goes through like two doors and he's like outside in the Uber.
I know a shortcut. I'm like, I'm just. How do you know where? Just follow me.
Yeah.
Yo, what were you about to say? But what were you about to say about regular niggas?
No, because it's been so long since I worked a corporate job that I don't even remember like what is if you go to ask for a raise,
mm-hmm.
what is a raise put like a percentage? That's not wild disrespect.
I've never had a job where I could ask for a raise.
Yeah,
all my jobs was like, yo, here's like a little 5% raise.
Damn.
Yeah. And it was like, be happy for that.
Yeah, you fucking count.
And you know what? At the time, I was like, I'm like, fuck it, I have to be happy for it. This is all I'm getting.
Because when I worked in the corporate, they were giving niggas the wild like 1.5%. 2%, like, I'm like, yo, what is this, bro?
I remember,
like,
I was going out with a girl at the time, she got a Christmas bonus. My job didn't give Christmas bonuses. I've never had a job that gave Christmas bonuses. Uh-huh. She got a Christmas bonus and spent it on like a bike, like a wild expensive mountain bike. And I was like, where'd you get that money from? She was like, my Christmas bonus. I was like, what the fuck is that?
What is that?
She's like, my job gives me extra money at the end of the year, like, for working there. And I was like,
what is this?
I can't even get my job to give me the money
that they fucking earned.
What kind of life is this?
What is happening?
Well,
yo, see? But yo, some of y'all, man, I mean, some people be happy with corporate jobs. I'm not.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, I'm too dark. I'm too hard-headed. I'm too opinionated. I'm too Jamaican to work a corporate job, as you guys can see from my old tweets and shit.
Yeah.
Shout to me never, you know, taking my boss behind the shed.
True.
Can't close it very numerous times. You know, We all riding our own horses.
That's true.
Some of our horses are the Silverhawk horses from the cartoon in the 80s.
Yo, are we going to buy horses? That's like a rich nigga thing to do, right? Have, like, buy a racehorse?
You have a daughter now, yes. You have to get her a pony. You have to get her a pony, Mero.
That's true. I got to find out how much a horse is.
They're very expensive.
Like 50 grand?
That's much more.
More than $50,000? Stop it. Like a racehorse. Like, not like the top of the line, like.
What, you get a sick horse now? You get your horse from Bronx Toyota?
A horse that's almost glue.
Almost glue? How are you going to get your daughter a refurbished horse?
Refurbished horse. Yeah. Oh, shit.
I know someone going to hop in the mentions with like.
An equestrian trained horse is over $250,000. Plus the insurance and the stable fees. You're looking at $500,000 easily.
Wow. It's like $45,000 a year.
A year?
Yes.
You gotta lease horses? You can't even just cop the shit out of it?
No, that's like to just maintain the horse. Like,
wow!
The horse can't live with you in your house. You can't have that shit in the garage with the Kawasaki.
I don't think I do with the lawnmower.
I know you're moving the Bergen, but listen, like.
I'm gonna get your garbage and shit, like old French fry boxes and shit. Like,
just eat it for no shit. Your neighbors are like, I heard your horse moaning. I think he might be sick.
He's laying on his side in my yard. He shit on my porch.
Mero, your horse is wandering the neighborhood again.
It bit my son.
Who's gonna clean up this? Who's gonna clean up this mess?
Neighbor's tight as fuck. Nigga just come out the crib and step in the wild horse shit.
He kicked my wife in the head. This enough is enough. At the community board, like, yeah. Enough. You thought I was being racist. I told you when they moved into this cul-de-sac, it was nothing but problems. And it's not because he's Dominican, and it's not because they're a Jew. They're beautiful kids and everything. But the horse. Oh my God, the horse. It doesn't even have horseshoes. I think it was wearing Yeezys.
Yo, horse walking to the ball in Yeezys. Yo, fucking horse bites hurt. So.
Is this another PSA from Big Horse?
Big Horse. Horse bites hurt.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff. You got to get employees. You have to get you got to get hay, straw, grain, vitamins, bandages.
Wow.
Someone to take care of the horse and shit. You can't have your mother fly up from DR and be like, yo, DK, watch the horse and my kids.
Watch the horse. My mom rides the horse to fucking Western beef and shit.
Oh, shit. Oh, man.
Shout out to my mom for knowing how to ride a horse. You know what I'm saying? And a doggy.
Well, not in the Bronx, though.
Not in the Bronx. In the Cross Bronx.
I feel like that definitely ends with the cop shooting. Go around.
That fucking Bruckner shit.
Using Waze.
Turn left. Recalculating.
Oh, wow.
Damn.
Oh, man. Listen. Yeah, so you got to buy a racehorse. I have no idea how we got
into racehorses.
I feel like at some point we're talking about Uber animals overnight, yep. But that had nothing to do with. You see how strong the brand is? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? The brand is strong.
We just go back. You know what I'm saying?
Just out here. We didn't even go back, but we started forward and we came back. We're like Looper if Looper was good. Was Looper good? I never saw it either,
but I didn't think it was. It didn't get great reviews. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I don't really go by reviews. I like to experience shit for myself while very smacked. You know what I'm saying?
In the smack city.
But. I hate that it might be whack because it's a dope concept and it's a fun thing to reference in a joke. And if the movie's whack, it kind of makes the joke like, because some people be like, I never saw that shit. Or some people be like, I saw that shit was whack. You know? I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking too much. Skittles.
It's gas. Are you okay? Relax. Relax. You are so smack right now.
It's the gas.
You're in a safe space. Relax.
Yo, this really feels like the wild safe space. You know what I mean? Like, it's mad. Like, there's like Red Bulls in the fridge.
Yeah, I feel like we could probably survive a bomb blast in this city, right? Yeah.
This shit didn't get damaged by the fire, right?
Nah.
Not at all.
Red Bull's built. It's tough. All right? Don't be drinking them other fucking energy drinks
whack
out there.
Energy drinks with corny
names.
Catch
you out there with a monster or a rock star. You ain't no rock star.
You know what I mean? Other energy drinks don't got soccer teams.
I was mad hurt. There's a beautiful Red Bull ad out right now, and they got like the epic music, and they got niggas doing like front flips with the BMX shit. Oh. And like, and I was like, damn, me and Mero should have been in that. Like, you know how it's ended, like, yo.
You know what I mean? like, yo, wow, like doing a front flip with the mic.
It's wild shit. Like, I don't know, flipping mics with their on fire.
Hell yeah, yo.
Soon, though.
Running on the turntables.
Because the brand is strong. The international takeover.
Fucking brolic.
Shout out to Hypnotic. We dropped
the live show.
Live show on Monday.
You're welcome.
You're getting so much fucking art right now.
Bruh. Like, it's wild. And this shit is so lit, too. Like,
it's lit. We're not mad at it. I was about to complain, but then it's just like, oh, was I not just talking about my terrible job not even 3 minutes ago, maybe?
True.
So, you know.
Yeah, I hear Mazel Tov.
Just give it hope. Uh-huh. Kicking the truth to young black youth. Damn, I got to catch up with you with the kids, huh? I got to start having some kids.
You can have a kid. I mean, like, yo, it's not for everybody. But I will say this. One kid is mad manageable. You know what I'm saying? So, start with one.
I think so. I got a dog. How hard?
Yeah.
It's not that much.
Yo, you got a dog, and you also, like, you actually really take care of your dog. So right. You're taking a nigga to the vet, you get mad medicine, you buying a nigga shoes and shit. It's literally like you have a child already. Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying?
All right. I'll probably make that jump in 2017.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, shit. All
right.
We'll Matt, I just heard like mad nipples getting hard. That vibration you feel is all the uteruses.
Yes. The uteri.
Uteri.
Uteri. Uteruses. Uterus? Uteri. All
right.
Nah, I just made up.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like it should be. Because octopus is octopi.
Octopi is delicious, actually, when you go to City Island.
Shut that. Yo,
are we gonna get famous to the point we can't go to City Island without security?
No.
I
mean, like, well, yeah, but like, nah, because we're gonna be good. Like, Millie Rock on any block, like, niggas ain't gonna try that shit.
Nah,
I feel like, you know.
Also, because people in the Bronx, they don't want to give you shine. They'd be like, it's fucking Jesus.
Yeah, and also like our Bronx friends and shit that we hang with, like, they're still gonna be around. Like, they're not gonna be like, yo, fuck y'all.
Yeah,
they might be there, and they'll definitely snuff somebody because they, you know what I'm saying.
Also, like, people don't really be fighting you. They're like, they might be like, oh, there's Jesus.
Yeah,
that's it. Maybe someone come over, ask for a photo or something. Yeah, but
I feel like
chill.
I used to hear all these wild stories of like rappers shit reading magazines and shit like that.
Yeah,
and like. In the 90s, it was wild. Like, yo, we went to the tunnel. Yo, it was 50 niggas fighting. Ah, whatever. And I'm just like, it's not like that anymore. Like, I could go to City Island and, like, nobody's going to try to jump me.
Well, I don't know. Maybe it's like that for Lil Yachty and shit.
Oh, true.
Maybe just, I don't think Lil Yachty could go to City Island.
Niggas try to jump me on fucking City Island.
Oh shit.
Man,
nah, cause we all about peace. So it's like we don't have like beefs and shit.
Man, it's not a beef, bro. We out here doing art, nigga. Like,
we got beef with Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump.
Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
And Wiz Khalifa.
I mean, we don't really got beef with Wiz Khalifa. Like, I feel like if he ran up on us and was like, yo, why y'all, hey dog, Desus, man, Mero, why y'all always saying fuck me?
What
I do to y'all?
You know what?
Why, dog?
Let my man Popcorn tell you.
Fuck Wiz Khalifa.
He'd be like, nah, I still don't understand. I was like, nah. I was like, remember the sound class?
It was a joke, man.
He'd be like, what? The sound what?
Sound what?
I've never been to England.
He's showing pictures. He's like, yo.
Oh, shit.
Where was this?
This is, haters gonna say this is Photoshop.
Yeah.
He don't know.
He don't know, man. He don't care.
Cause he's at that point.
He's wild rich, right? He's definitely wild rich.
You wanna know how rich Wiz Khalifa is? This was his tweet about Donald Trump becoming president. And the less bothered you were about Donald Trump becoming president, that's how much money he had.
That's true.
Where is it?
That's a perfect, parabola.
What is it? Oh, yeah. His tweet was, crazy that dude is president, but we all got lives to live, so let's not focus on a negative.
All right.
That's a big money tweet.
All right.
Now, you do that shit from the back of your Bentley, like, I'm about to go get the wild Swedish fish caviar toppy.
If I would have drafted that tweet, I would have thought about it and then been like, nah. You know what I'm saying? But he got so much money that he was just like, let it fly.
Every now and then
don't care.
Every check, you get a little more removed from society.
Wow, I can't wait.
You know?
I can't wait till I'm totally disconnected from society and I'm like living in this huge house in Malibu. And I'm just like, yo, what day is it?
Wait till 2020 and that hard election, Kanye versus President Trump going for a second term.
Oh my God.
And I get off that fucking fire. Let's not make a mistake that we made 4 years ago. Re-elect Trump, Trump chain, MAGA again, choo-choo, blacks for Trump.
Blacks for Trump.
Jamaicans for Trump.
Oh my God. Yo, I hope that by 2020, the Dominican guy that just got into Congress is
going to run against him?
Runs for president. That'd be super lit.
So they find embarrassing photos of him doing shit at La Marina?
Yeah.
And I'm in the background like, yo.
Yo, we lit, huh? Nigga, we out here, squad. He's just like with the wild, I think it's at like fucking the wild titty bar and shit with just like mad cheeks in his face, like, yo.
It's gonna do you down for. I feel, you know, like that can't really ruin people. Listen,
yeah, man.
Trump ran with like all types of wild shit. His wife got the dudes and everything.
That's what I'm saying. Like, so about shit like no more. Precisely. So, like, now you can't even say, like, you can't even bring that up no more. Like, yo, he's a wild scumbag because Trump is a wild scumbag. He's president.
We said it early on this podcast. Facts don't matter. Facts do not matter for this whole election. Now we're gonna see.
At all.
Now we're gonna see what happens.
And we found out that not only do facts matter, reputation doesn't matter either. It doesn't matter if you're a wild fucking dickhead.
Because, you know, Crooked Hillary.
You know what I mean?
Crooked. I'm missaying that. Crooked Hillary. She's going to disappear. Where's she going now?
She's not. She's cooked. She ran for president twice and got washed twice. It's quiet.
Yeah, she's like the Ronda Rousey. What's her name?
That's it. Ronda Rousey. Got knocked out what?
But she's the Ronda Rousey of politics now?
Got knocked out twice. It's quiet.
She was secretary of, she was running shit.
Yeah.
Damn, that was quiet. Well, it's not really quiet. She can still do speeches and get good money and shit.
Nah, man, it's quiet.
It ain't the same.
She's like Patrick Ewing, B. She had the wild, she was right there. Career. She was right
she
there.
She was right there,
twice.
Though.
Twice.
Damn.
And
she blew that 3-1 lead.
Yep. Shit the bed, B. Listen, man, what you fucked up was being like, yo, hey, we're not Trump. You had to come harder than that, B. You couldn't just come like, yo, well, we're not Trump. Trump was like, yeah, you're not me. I'm here for every man. Every working class white guy who is out here in the streets.
Well, I mean, you can't really blame her. You also have to like blame other things. You have to blame like the FBI getting involved. Yeah. You have to blame Facebook's fucking fake news feed, like doing shit, Russian hackers. Yeah. A lot of shit was going on. There's a lot of things we need to look into.
Yeah.
So also, them changing like the voting hours and early voting stopped people from voting. Mm-hmm. A lot of people like people didn't vote, and it was like, yo,
long
people
waits.
Couldn't vote.
Yep.
Long waits and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, my man, let Hill Dogs out here cook, man.
Yeah.
Hillary, you good money. Come on. Hillary, come on the show and spit the real now. Now you don't gotta worry about nothing. You can say what you really think about Donald Trump.
Because I know you don't want to say this shit in there.
You want to say like, yo, come on, you could curse.
Keep it 100.
We got Skittles weed.
Yep.
You don't even gotta wear a pantsuit.
The pantry is super lit. I know you fuck with like Kind bars and shit like that. Luna bars. They got them shits in the pantry all day.
How you talking about the Vice Land shit? No, I'm talking about Bodega Boys.
Oh, both.
Because you can be wilder on Bodega Boys than you can be on
for
this
sure.
shit. They should come on this shit and be like, yo, fuck Donald Trump.
Fuck Donald Trump, nigga.
Yo, I'll beat that. I'll beat the brakes off Melania if I ever see her and shit.
Fucking pussy. Yo, just wish I see that bitch.
She's just there with the blunt. I'm like, yo, could you hurry up with the... Just hurry up with the blunt, though.
Are you fucking bugging? I'm Hillary, nigga.
I'm just saying.
I'm chiefing. Let me get high, nigga.
You wasn't commanding and chiefing.
Oh!
Trying to fight me.
Then she just starts scrapping and shit like.
Yo, Hillary, chill,
Hillary. Fuck out of here, nigga. Hillary. You think it's a fucking game, nigga? You think it's a fucking game? How about these rip shots, huh?
Hillary, chill, Hill. Chill, Hill.
No chilling, Hill.
Chill, Hill. I thought you was cooling in Little Rock. I thought you were just chilling.
Yo.
Hillary, what do you feel the election was rigged?
Nigga, life is rigged. Capo told you that. You heard it. He told you live on your special.
Your Hillary just turned
into Ben Carson. Fucking smack.
Smack.
Oh, man.
That'd been good. Well,
yo, but Jim Jones did say that life was rigged.
He did on the election special.
And he wasn't lying.
The only election special that had Cardi B, Jim Jones, Talib Kweli, and Krishna. From We The Kids. That was cool. That was cool counter programming.
Yeah.
I don't know what else was on that night because, you know, again, it was a live show, but
it got picked up by a lot of people, and they were saying that
it was fun, a
nice departure from the depression. That's
what
America
we're trying to do.
Yeah, man, come on.
We're trying to lift spirits, lift every voice and sing, you know what I'm saying?
We know shit is hard, man, but listen, our lives have been hard.
Get some nudes in the DMs.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yo, live through us, B, because our lives were very hard prior to this, you know what I'm saying? And they're getting better.
Yeah. We should be inspirational to
that's
y'all.
Right.
Don't be a hater.
Don't be a hater. Just be
most people aren't haters. Like most people are like they're supporters. They're like they're encouraging proud. They're proud of the come up.
Yeah.
The brand is strong.
Yo, I feel like, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to say everybody, but I feel like most people are inherently nice. You know what I'm saying?
I think it's from what I would say something like 99%.
Yeah.
Like you have like people trolling. Mm-hmm. But most people generally are happy. So, you know, we do this for y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Do all the shows on the podcast.
That's right.
Happy people holding a shiny, happy people holding. Yo, what's ASCAP or the RIA finds out about this shit? They're going to get us some payment is due, sir. One Paul Simon heard your last episode. Uh-huh.
That's right.
No. Yeah. All that. Yeah. Here's a check.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Are you going to the fucking bank?
He was like, yo, sit down.
Illegal usage.
Nah, we
gotta corny though, though. That's corny. We're bringing awareness, B. Like, yo, you know how many people at 20 years old listen to this shit, have no idea who the fuck Simon and Garfunkel is?
But you know
and
what?
We just put them on.
That's the rules. Them's the rules. That's they true. Changed after it was Biz Markie had an album and it was like some ruling about samples. And after that.
Oh, yeah. That's the historical.
They started changing laws and shit about samples and songs and then uploading them on YouTube and SoundCloud. And before it was like real media.
Damn,
and Winamp.
Media?
Damn. All that. We talked about Winamp before. Yeah. The Llama.
The Llama. Damn. Shout out to Kazaa.
Kazaa. Even iTunes. Because remember when iTunes first came out, it wasn't Apple Music. It was like, yo, you physically bought the song.
Yeah.
And they had like, what was it, MP4 format or M4A or some shit like
some
that?
Some shit like that. And mad people were like, fuck out of here. I'm not paying for no fucking MP3. And it was like, that shit's supposed to be free. And then you're like, actually.
Because we got used to it being free.
Yeah.
Thanks to MP3 hacking groups like CMS, Ego, and RNS. Bah, 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 bah.
Oh, shit. Yo, like, the 15 people that are going to get that are going to be so hyped.
Mm-hmm. At their corporate job. Hell yeah. Like, why hasn't Jesus grown up yet? That was years ago.
They just went like this. Like, yeah.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, bro.
I remember that.
RNS till he died. And they're like, Dad, what are you talking about? Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
I'm working on a minivan.
I was the first person to rip Confessions of Fire.
Oh, wow. Really? Yes.
Yeah, see? A little internet history for you. Oh, I feel like episode 12, I was like, this nigga just got a text that made him make a face. And I was about to do the same thing, but then I just did.
No, that was my brother-in-law. He was asking me about sneakers.
Oh, okay. Are you his plug? You're his plug?
No.
No?
Nah, I'm nobody's plug. I'm my own plug.
He's off, yeah.
My own plug. I'm a made man. I get my sneakers for myself. Right. By myself. Right. On myself.
Born alone.
For
die
myself.
Alone. Sneak
you know
alone.
Ain't no love in the sneaker world.
Just me and my bots.
Don't ask for no oops. Don't ask for no retweets. You know what I'm saying? Don't ask me to gift me no purchases.
Yo.
You know what I mean?
Have you found a pair of sneakers yet? Because I know you cop all your shit. Mm-hmm. Like, you don't do, like, trades with niggas and shit like that. And go
no
to
trades.
And, like,
cop.
Trading and shit. Yeah.
Straight cop. And only dead stock. Well, actually, no. I have purchased a pair of used sneakers that I really, really, really wanted, and they were rare, but, you know.
I was going to say, like, what pair of sneakers would make you be like, yo, I don't care that somebody's worn these, like, for a month. I need these. You know what I'm saying?
That's, you know what? I don't have that. I don't even have that. Because the last pair of sneakers I really wanted was, damn, I can't even, who even knows? It's whatever now.
See, that's how you know. He's getting bread, bro.
It's not fun, though.
See, he's getting
you know
bread.
Saying?
He's just waking up like, let's see. What released today?
I don't buy, I don't get sneaker, I don't get every sneaker that comes out. Right. Like, I'm kind of picky with
it.
But
no, you can't get everything like, that comes out. A lot of shit that comes out is whack.
Yeah, also, yeah, I feel like Jordan, you know, like, they've been bringing some heat. But not like heat. I know I want the triple black boosts that are coming out. The Adidas, those are dropping soon. Those are gonna be hard to get. So I'm excited for that. Cause also it's a challenge to get them.
Right.
Can you know, do you got a back door? Do you got a plug that got them like a week early and you have to pay extra for it? Can you like run your bots? You know what I'm saying? You got your bots out there.
You know, that's ill. I respect it because people used to look at me like I was nuts when I'd be like, yo, when I do graffiti, like this shit is like a rush.
Right.
Like, yo, am I gonna get away with this? Like, I'm gonna go stay in here on camera and do this whole shit. Like
gets endorphins going.
Oh,
you know?
Man, so good.
Yeah.
Do what you love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Because I remember it was one Christmas. I think I wanted the grape fives or some shit like that. And, wait, was that? No, it wasn't the grape fives. It was a, what am I saying?
Grape fives?
No, the grape eights.
It's just a strap?
Yeah. And I think it was like a re-release or some shit. Mm-hmm. And I thought the chick I was seeing was going to get them for me. And she got me some other shit. And so I was so tight that day. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah. This one, you said the Grape 8s. Shout out to my man Jimmy, who was in the same situation. He wanted to cop the Grape 8s. He copped them on eBay.
No, it was actually the 5 retros.
5 retros?
Yeah, the Grape 5s, I guess you call them. But then it was like something about, oh, that's not really what they're called or whatever.
Yo, see?
I'm going to get cooked in my comments for this, but whatever.
Don't be
facts don't matter.
Don't nitpick.
Don't be a Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we all here having fun, conversation. We're smacking and deckling.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're just moving and grooving.
Yeah.
Getting these words percolating into 12 with each other.
You know
and then you come with the,
yo, actually, those are the Concord 11.5 Flyknit upper.
Actually, those aren't technically Jordans because Jordan was very sick that day and he had the flu, so we had to borrow Scottie Pippen sneakers. Exactly. So we actually call those the Air Pippins Rare Limited Retros.
Yeah, they have the 48 on the back from when he played at the Hoop It Up tournament in Michigan.
I have every Jordan ever made in size 13. Like, what the fuck?
Size 13, nigga, I'll smack you.
Size 13, that's not really a goal. That's not a normal foot size.
Yeah, no.
Is it
even a flex? Bro, if you have like a size 4 foot or like a size 28.5, like is that a flex getting
sneakers? It's not, but they be having the sneakers.
Like,
it's a sneaker report.
Like, nigga, I don't know who wears a size 18. You know what I'm saying? Of course you're getting those fours.
I bet,
you know,
there's, I mean, definitely, like, someone who wears a size 18. They're like, damn, niggas be roasting me all day about my feet size. To escape from that, I like to listen to Bodega Boys.
Sorry.
Yeah. Do, 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 do.
Niggas are cooking.
He's just walking down the street with his long ass feet, sad like, as fuck. Trip
flop,
on him.
Like flop, flop, flop. Fucking big ass clown shoes. Nigga be a clown for Halloween every Halloween because the shoes fit.
What are you for? I'm not a clown. I'm
not
a doctor.
I'm a doctor.
I'm a doctor. Dude, we look like Dr. Clown with them long ass feet. Look at
clown,
his
nigga.
Tugboat feet.
Tugboat. Yo, niggas are making fun of Carl Anthony Towns wearing Tims because his feet literally look like tugboats in Tims.
Listen.
But yo, best basketball players.
He got talent. He got money. He be all right.
Yeah, he be all right. Nigga's a millionaire.
You get money, you get it compensates people making fun of you for stuff.
Yo, so. If you're a millionaire, yo, if I was a millionaire, you couldn't make fun of me. I'd be like, nigga, I'm a millionaire. Get the fuck out of my face. You stupid. Like, I'll buy you lunch. Nigga.
You need to be a millionaire or Christ. That's how you get right.
Shout out to Facebook for all my titties, all the titties of the world being like, Jesus is my president.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
so it doesn't matter what happens on this earthly realm. Because I know where my vote was cast.
So ill. My uncle.
I was like, yo, get that folk out of here.
My uncle wrote fucking this whole thing, like, I don't know where this country's headed, blah, 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 blah. But in my house, we follow the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
In all caps. Like, I was like, all right. I mean, you still got to pay taxes, nigga.
Wow. Okay, apparently 4 years ago today, I was hanging with Mayor Nutter.
Oh, shit.
That's old Jesus.
Oh, shit, look at Mayor Nutter.
With no facial hair.
Looking like a Dominican uncle.
Out there, man. People would think that was my ex-girlfriend's father for that photo. That's when I was in my politics. Had my pocket squares and shit.
Shout out to Mayor Nutter.
Yeah. Now look, I'm on TV now. Talking about sleepers.
Yo.
Available for $2.99 all this weekend at Amazon Video.
Tune in. Don't miss out.
Amazon Video, the best place to watch it now.
Also, sign up for Amazon Prime for free 2-day shipping on all items.
Bill, how did you get 2 Amazon Prime placements on Bodega Boys?
His wife calls him.
He gonna
hey,
wake up like,
"How's it going? Hey, how are you? How you doing?
I heard you had a. I heard Bodega Boys and a. You know, maybe you get your dick sucked twice this year.
What the fuck is everybody talking about?
He's like, what? He's gonna wake up with all these congrats emails, like, congrats, great grab. He's gonna be like, what? I hate this fucking job. What are they talking about?
What are they talking about?
It was like the day he was gonna come shoot up the office. He's like, well, I guess. He's like, they're fucking with me. As he's opening the trunk of his car to get the AR-15, so his hand is on his thing, like, great job. He's like,
awesome job, Bill.
Oh
my
okay.
God. Bodega, man. What a
wow. You got the earth right in the.
What a get.
Wow. Someone's getting a corner office. He's just like, he's been the rest of the day highly suspicious.
Like, I don't know.
He has no idea what Bodega Boys is.
Yeah.
Fucking listening to every episode, trying to figure out what the mention is.
What the fuck?
You're welcome, Bill. We're benevolent. We're benevolent bodega guys.
Hell yeah, we're feeling mad positive today.
We just picked you out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere, man, G.
I just gave you the placement.
You're welcome. I'm just looking at that little Skittles.
You go home, and for the first time in your life, your wife is going to look you in your face, because the first time in your life, she's going to feel like you're a man.
That's right.
And your kids are going to be like, hey, Dad. And they're not going to punch you in your nuts
that's
as soon as
right.
you walk in.
You're going to disrespect you.
You're going to get the big piece of steak-em. Because you voted for Trump. And you live in a wild trailer park. You asshole.
Fucking dick. Damn, imagine.
It's a, hey, listen, it's imagine. Circle. Time is a flat circle.
Time is a flat circle.
Everything comes around.
What goes around, comes around.
No more singing. All right, I said, no more singing. This shit ain't Glee, nigga. That's literally what the message, the email they sent us was. This shit ain't Glee, nigga.
Chill. With the fucking stopping hands.
The stop. Like, just mad emojis and shit. The angry red face.
A little fucking snap, fucking smoke blowing at your nostrils joint. Yeah.
If you want to sing something, sing some shit from Empire.
Fuck out of here.
Is Empire still popping? I heard it still comes on.
I mean, it does. I got like 3 episodes on a DVR.
Remember when you used to like suck off Empire? Ah, it's so good.
I mean, it used to be. Yo, it happens
with
a lot of shows.
I'm not gonna lie, it was good. Everyone,
it happens
it was
with a lot
good.
Of shows. They saw a lot of shows start off strong and then peter out.
Damn, I can't wait for our show to start like petering out.
You know what I mean?
Niggas don't even care anymore. Niggas don't. Like, our clothes are all linty and shit. Yeah. I'm not getting haircuts.
Yeah.
Mero show. Let's start doing the shit that Morning Joe does. Have you ever watched that show?
Man.
Sometimes he comes in while the show is going on already.
Really?
Like, that should be going for like an hour already and he just shows up.
Like, yo, what's good?
Because it's his show. What are they going to do?
It's the dude with the glasses?
Yeah. That the guy that was giving Donald Trump all the, like, the phone interviews and, you know, and then the next day he's like, well, how did he win?
I don't understand how this happened. America, how'd you know?
But he used to be a congressman in Florida, so, you know, he's really a reptile.
Low-key, yeah.
He's a reptile person.
Yeah, low-key he voted for Trump.
You know, not even low-key. High-key.
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 Did he say, like, I'm voting for Trump?
I don't know.
Because I mean, you say that and then be like, how did this happen? Yo, that nigga's a clown cake, bro. Like, these are, yo, listen, man. One thing I learned from being in entertainment is that these motherfuckers are just regular people, bro. They just do something really good. Or they got lucky. You know what I'm saying?
Or they're white.
Yeah. They got lucky to be born white.
Is it lucky to be born white?
I mean, in America, it is.
Well, it is lucky because, I mean,
because you didn't choose to. It just happened to you. You got, you know what I'm saying? You got the holy blessing of Donald Trump.
No, not really. I mean, if you think about it, it's very rare that you'd be born white because, remember, they were invented by Dr. Yaku.
That's true.
In caves.
That's true.
Genetic splicing.
You know what I'm saying?
Stay woke. It's about phenotypes.
Kissing wolves.
Mm-hmm.
This is about phenotypes.
They don't have the melanin. That's our secret. Peanuts and sunlight. That's how we're going to get them out the paint.
Yeah. Oh, man. What if Mr. Peanut ran for president?
Hell no.
Approval rating is in the tubes. Mr. Peanut, the most hated candidate.
Boo. Get out of here.
Peanut Man and his running mate, Gluten, got 0% of the white vote.
And now we go straight to the inauguration for Mayor Mr. Mayo Sandwich. Delicious. And his running mate, Ants on the Log.
Yo! Oh my god!
Ah, racism!
Yo, Chobani's fucking Secretary of State.
No, if you laughed at that, you're a bigot for us being bigots, recognizing that. Because that's what being a bigot is. Yeah. It's recognizing another
bigot.
So, you know what I'm saying? Gang. Shout out Bigot Gang out here. Bigotry. We're going to get Bigot Gang t-shirts.
Bigot
Gang. Yo, you down with BG, brother?
Yo, can we start like a neo soul, like, neo duo soul and call it Bigotry?
Bigotry?
You know what I'm saying?
You said that, and I just thought automatically of just yo. Sorry, Bigotry. I just no. Flowetry had a unplugged on MTV, and they were like sitting back to back. And I just started being you.
The tie-dye sundresses and shit back to back.
We just got like tunics on that. I got the Eric Benet sandals with toe rings. I got a fucking arm tattoo on my arm and shit. I somehow have escrow. That shit is wild. That shit is wild greasy underneath the stage lights.
Oh my god.
Oh shit. We don't even have seats. We have like fucking big ass pillows. We're just kind of lying on them.
Yo,
your man Mero got a shirt showing all the chest hair,
all of it,
just, you know, out there, it's plucked out. Fuck.
Mad linen.
Oh, he got the A-Rod blonde highlights.
Got the wild like fucking cheesecloth bandana shit tied around my head, looking all wild.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying? Rubbing mad shea butter on my chest. Mm. You know what I mean?
For all my ladies out there getting those transit checks.
You know what I mean? Girl, you appreciate it. Mm. My queen. On the 4 train.
When I swipe for you and me.
Girl, love is necessary when you are selling candy for your basketball team.
You took the local to my heart, but I wanna go express.
Girl.
See? So MTA related. Or MTA related rhymes.
Holla.
MTA cut the check.
Holla.
Me and Mero will be performing at Grand Central.
All day.
After the guy from Peru with the pan flutes.
Yo, what makes me so mad?
Got my computer started like Zelda.
Y'all about to go get that sword. Fuck that.
Y'all getting the hammer and I'm breaking that rock. Fuck that. Yo. Hold this chicken.
Hold this chicken. Yo, I'm gonna be running around with the chicken over his head. Yo, this shit gets me tight though, because that's the type of shit that ends up on videos and entices people that are not from New York to move to New York.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, it's so whimsical. Remember the dude that was playing like the drums to Rihanna and shit? And everybody was like dancing. I was like, bro, that's not what it's really like.
First of all, you want to spend as little amount of time inside a subway station as possible.
Precisely.
Like, you don't be having no dance party or shit.
Nah.
Lorimer Station is kind of lit. No, what is the one over by us? Bedford? Bedford? Bedford is
alright. Yeah.
I stopped a fight there once.
Yeah?
Yeah, like mad years ago. I had a BlackBerry. That's how long ago it was. And I was coming for some weird, I got invited to like an art party, and it was like a warehouse, and yeah. I did not know what was going on and shit, and I coughed during someone's film, and people got really mad, but on the way back, and I was tight, because I was like, there gotta be food here, and the only thing around was like fucking that pizzeria, like that was like the only thing, because it was still like, Williamsburg was still kind of rough, and it was like a guy was getting bullied by like four big Italian guys, and I was like telling them to leave him alone,
because
I was mad drunk. And they fell back.
Oh, shit.
Stand here with me.
All right, bro. Sorry, bro. You know what I'm saying? Didn't mean to.
I think they were going to fuck him up, too. I was tight because I figured I was so mad because I knew I had the wild commute home. I had to take the L to the 2, all this shit.
That's the
and I was like, yo, if they start fighting and the cops come and the L train don't come through here, I'm going to be fucking, I'm going to fuck everyone up. So I was like, oh, y'all not going to do that. I was like, you stand over here. Y'all stay over there. Like, let this train come to the fucking station. Play around with my time.
Yo, chill, bro. You might have a gun, bro.
Paying too much money for PBRs and shit.
God, that sucks.
Yeah. Well, listen.
Shout out to Williamsburg. Yo, shout out to those. Yo, but yo, that like those warehouse parties out there used to be like
used to be lit.
Oof.
Used to be lit. Come full circle. We used to. I used to go to warehouse parties. Now, hopefully, God willing, I can take one of your sacred clubs or restaurants in Williamsburg.
Yep.
Tear it down
yep.
and turn it into a 3-story house
right.
just for my sneakers.
Made out of glass.
Wait till I tear down output and it's just for my Jordans. You're gonna be sick. We used to party here, dudes. I don't care.
Fuck that.
Get away from my sneaker closet.
Fuck out of here.
Boop, boop.
You're fucking up the humidity levels.
You see the whole shit just raise it up.
Man, futuristic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man.
Wow. Everything.
Damn. Can't wait. Niggas about to be rich, bro.
No, we're not. It's not gonna happen.
Nope.
We're gonna it's gonna be just one bad tweet or just one hot mic. It's all downhill.
Can't wait.
The Parisian community is still waiting on the fifth day for an apology from the kid Mero for his comments on Tuesday's Desus and Mero.
I'm like, I don't even know what the fuck I said, yo.
He knows what he said.
I don't know what the fuck it is.
What he said was very disrespectful.
What do you mean?
They're going to cover all the graffiti.
All I said was freedom fries.
See, he said it again. He said it again. Why would you do that?
Speaking of French.
French Montana, what happened to him? He died?
No. Nah, he's chilling. Nah, that's what we were talking about. Dave Chappelle said he might do Saturday Night Live. You were saying that, was that the last episode that he said that he wasn't going to show up? He said
he's probably going to show up because he shot the preview.
They're gonna try
opening and shit.
Yeah,
this is a podcast. Doesn't matter. Don't look at my lips, nigga.
Yeah, man. I mean, it's very distracting.
The fuck is that? Don't you doing that shit?
I was looking at the
Saint Moonlight, nigga. No, I mean, I say that Moonlight is a very touching coming of age movie.
It's a touching film. I haven't seen it, but it's a touching film.
What was the last movie you saw?
In the theaters?
Yeah.
Sicario.
Oh.
That movie with Benicio del Toro and shit and fucking Julie Chastain, I think.
All right.
Emily Blunt.
Did you see that in Smack City Cinemas?
I was wild smack, but it was a dope movie. It was about like the cartel shit and the hitman. You know what I'm saying? And like they had a dude that was like, it was wild. It was wild. Just go watch it. It's a really good movie. And I had the screener. You know what I'm saying?
So all right.
I saw the theater and then I got the screener at the crib. I watched it again. Smack.
Smacked?
Yeah.
That's good.
That's fun time.
Well,
Moonlight was the last movie you saw?
Yeah, so you know I'm out here. I'm trying to get cultural.
No spoilers. Was it good?
It was very good.
All right.
Excellent movie. Makes you think.
Okay.
Makes you think about the future. You know, the future of the world and the future of like perhaps your daughter.
Right. What was the theme? That's what I was about to ask you. Like,
what do you mean? What is the theme?
Like, what is the message of the movie? Like, because you're talking about like
the message of the movie. Go see the movie. Don't let some nigga on a podcast ruin it for you. All right. Speaking of your daughter, now would be a great time to pick out the Baby Name Wizard Revised 3rd Edition, a magical method of finding the perfect name for your baby, available for $10.45, available today, and if you order by now, at November 11th, available by Amazon Prime.
Yo, Jeff Bezos is like jerking off to his podcast right now. He's like, oh yeah, I love it.
Fuck him. Yeah. He already came out like, yeah, I fuck with Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump.
Really? He did?
Yeah.
Wow. What?
But he been the worm.
You're a fucking worm, bro.
He's been the worm.
If you're mad rich, I mean, like, listen, if you're mad rich, I understand why you want to have the president in your pocket, but like, also if you're mad rich, it don't matter, B, because you're fucking rich. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Well, you gotta
already,
stay rich.
Yeah, but you're already finessing and to have your money like not in the United States, man. Like, stop fronting, bro. Like, just do your thing. Well, just say what you feel.
Amazon needs him to play nice with Trumpy. So
they need to. Oh, their numbers won't be Bigly.
Bigly.
They won't come through on some Bigly shit.
I mean, you know, they need that.
Are they doing
the tech people?
Shit yet?
And remember, he also owns Washington Post. So.
Oh, true.
You know what I'm saying.
Washington Post was cooking Donald Trump though. All election, right? Weren't they?
No, not at all.
They were supporting him? They were just giving him mad juice?
They were licking his balls. This was a political episode.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for it, but people needed that. That's what you got. We also got Mero and his kids.
That's right.
So you also got some ads from Amazon. Don't buy from Amazon unless you're going to use our referral code.
That's right.
It's 212 Red Bull.
Yo.
Red Bull could get all these fucking affiliate checks. Like, what are we doing with these? Where is it? Why are these? Like,
they're going to look at the fucking statements at the end of the year like, 48% of our profits was Amazon
affiliates?
For
a baby name book? And sleepers?
What? Yo, when you said that baby name shit, I thought there was like some baby name generator that just popped up with a name for free.
No, that's the book. That's the book that you to pick a name for your child. We're having a contest. If you make a video of you power chugging a Red Bull while naming Miro's daughter, you will get a free t-shirt.
Holla.
Nah, that's not happening. Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. Don't listen. That sounds like mad work for me. I'm not trying to watch mad videos of you power choking. I'll watch like two and then just pick the fifth one.
Like, oh, it's just boring. Unless you do something creative, like light yourself on fire while you do it. Don't do that.
Also, his daughter's name is going to be Miggy Azalea.
Miggy Azalea? It has to be an A name, but it's definitely not going to be Azalea. And that's, I seen that shit in the book and I just scoffed.
Why does it have to be an A?
Because all the other kids are A.
Oh,
right. Yeah, I'm just going to keep the trend going.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying?
Keep the pattern. Keep tradition alive.
You know what I'm saying?
I respect it. The way we've been keeping tradition alive for 47
That's
episodes.
That's right.
Of your favorite podcast.
Do your
the
best.
Bodega Boys. Live from the Octagon.
Fucking Octagon of Pain.
It's your boy, Desus Nice. AKA Desus Vice. AKA Young Chipotle. AKA Pasta State Fat Lake Terrio. AKA Chris Dashboard Slim Dick.
Yeah.
AKA Eli Litby. AKA Butchers Gully. Right. Slow but that might know your bitch. Young Day Party. Young Hot Take. Desus H. Fuego. Mr. Nanas with a Rondo. Mil Novaceta Noveta Equato. Mikhail going off the Juve boss.
Right.
The MC Lickle Gunga P. Putting up for 40 with your shorty. AKA Don't Talk to Me in the Uber Pool.
I don't know who you are.
You know what? I might change this to like. I'm in the Uber X. Like, there's no one to talk to me. Like, let's just be for real right here. The original plus one got a plus one, so don't make a fuss one.
Nope.
Desus Rotstein, the Jamaican Jew, eh? I would like to bring up Mero's horse bit me.
Yeah.
I pay a lot of property. I pay $53,000 a year in property taxes. Why is he allowed to move in here with all his kids and they just have their horse out here? I think the horse might be part pitbull. Young Pa! The ghost of Mufasa. Young Chacoonery without the coonery. A.K.A. Chile Lamone, the left-handed reliever for the Yankees. K.L.O.K. I pitched a perfect game off K2 in 1978.
Woo.
And then me and Reggie Jackson went and got sloppy toppy on Jerome Avenue.
Hey.
Vice K. Matsuzaka. Tufone Jones. Leonardo DiTrapio. Mr. Lara Marina in a mesh marina with fresh misdemeanor and a cold demeanor. AKA your problematic babe.
Yeah,
if you're trying to hook up with me, catch me in detention camp 14A4B under the reign of Emperor Trump.
Yo, and you're gonna have to call me long distance, get the phone calls because they're gonna send me back to the yard. It's your boy the Camaro, AKA the human durag flap, AKA I know fucking baby, I
know
fucking man, my nigga.
Respect
you, know
agency.
What I'm saying? That's right. Ben Smack Biyombo, Triz Khalifa, you know what I'm saying? East Street, my Stevie B. I will go to your house, I will open your medicine cabinet. I have no scruples. You know what I'm saying? Curve Gotti. You know what I'm saying? Motherfucking, I don't talk to cops. Donovan McDabb, nigga.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Fucking, the plantain supernova in the sky. I just turned around the mic. You niggas don't even know.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? If you see me in Target, don't approach me unless you know how to approach a fucking bear. You know what I'm saying? And also check the guest list again because my name is definitely on that shit. Holla.
Is it your real name or your talent name?
Both.
Which one do you
want? And I got a plus 10. Shut up and let me in.
I don't see your name here, sir.
Fuck out of it. We out.